Well, hey there, everybody. Today I'm doing an informational video on neon tube testers. There are a couple kinds available, and I thought I'd just show you what we have and the pros and cons of each. I'll start off with this electronic one. It is Chinese garbage, but it does work. They are powered by four AA batteries and have one button for the power. These are most effective when held against the neon electrode wire. They light up a small portion of the tube, but they do work a little if held on the glass. This is, they're kind of difficult to see in bright sunlight, so that's something to keep in mind. But they do have the advantage of being quite portable. You could stick this in your pocket and take it with you to, you know, a flea market or Craigslist meet up and see if you know, there's a broken neon sign, you can test which tubes are good, maybe kind of base your bid on that sort of thing. For these little tube testers, the sign supply shops will try to sell them for like $50, but you could find them easily on eBay and Amazon for $15, so check there. Next kind we have is this is called a spark coil. It's a handheld Tesla coil, and it is corded. So that is a disadvantage. You have to have a wall outlet within, you know, 8 feet or so. This is Electrotechnics Products. This is a model BD10AS. The S on the end means it has a switch. This is a momentary push button switch that activates the spark coil. It has interchangeable tips. So you can for example, they have a spring tip, or this is just the solid pointer tip. These are quite powerful. Manufacturer rates them output as 20,000 to 50,000 volts at 0.1 milliamps. So very high voltage, incredibly low amperage. They will light up almost an entire tube, depending on the length, of course. And they are adjustable for the variable output. So, watts. So, these are also useful for testing for leaks on a neon manifold when the tubes are getting pumped down before they are processed. Now, this runs manufacturer MSRP is about $288 at time of this video. So they are more expensive, but they are well built. They are heavy duty. They have a solid Bakelite case here, and they make replacement parts so you can repair it. This kind is, you know, more just kind of disposable. You do have to be careful with these spark coils. They are quite powerful. If you hold it in one place too long, it's possible to blow a hole in a thin part of the weld or a thin bend. So it's best to test them on the electrode wires. If you hold it too close, it can heat up the glass and cause the pinch seal to crack. So far out on the wires is good. One thing to mention about these is the safety of the device. It says in the instructions not to touch the aerial while the button is on, but it's obviously not doing anything. Although if I lift my finger off just slightly, it will arc to my skin. See, there you go. And leave a burn mark. So that's something to be aware of. It smells gross, but you know, doesn't really do much. This one being 50,000 volts. Feels more like kind of like a static electricity shock when you touch a doorknob, except it's, you know, like 100 times a second. So it's not comfortable, but unless you have like a pacemaker and a dodgy heart, it doesn't really do much. Along the same lines of this spark coil kind of device is there's a cheaper versions available. They sell them as high-frequency wands. This is essentially a modern violet ray, which was a quack medical device. They were supposed to use it for, I don't know, cosmetic purposes, I guess. And it is, you can tell, it looks similar to the spark coil. It is corded as well. Now these are also variable. They have a little adjustable dial. And with this in here, supposed to give a gentle electrical pulse to your skin. These high frequency units can also be used to test neon. They're not quite as powerful as a regular spark coil, but you could kind of fashion your own tip by attaching some sort of wire extension to that, like so. So these are relatively cheap and they're just pretty simple. I just got some circuit board and a heat sink and that's it. So these, you can find them, well, some sellers try to pawn them off for over $100 as if the fill gas matters in these little adapter tubes, but you could find them for $25 or so on eBay. As a high frequency wand, they also sell, are repackaged and sold as adult toys. It's the exact same thing, just packaged in a box with different labeling. So, and one other thing I wanted to try that I have thought about but never tested was one of these plasma arc lighters. Probably seen them before. They're battery powered USB rechargeable lighters and they shoot an arc. They're, you know, supposed to be windproof and all that. And I wanted to test it on a neon tube, see if it actually works. So let's see, let's find out. No. Okay, so I got to thinking about this and the other testers only have one contact, but this one has two, so we have to complete a circuit. I thought I could just maybe jumper one end to the electrode on one side and look at that. USB lighter powering a neon tube. Now, this is not very practical because you'd have to be able to carry a jumper wire and it's kind of finicky because it wants to take the path of least resistance and usually that's just directly across the contacts like so. But turns out we can get it to do that. That's pretty fun. But anyway, we have cheap electronic. Portable, limited in its abilities, and then we have the expensive but very capable handheld spark coil. So, anyway, I hope this was informative. Hit subscribe for more neon-related videos, and we'll see you next time. It's working!